Sabina Child's curtain refers to the move as unfair after highlighting the wording of a letter that she had received from Scotia Bank. According to the letter, persons would be charged $2 for each transaction through the ATM or through a teller.
We have other increase coming up. I'm thinking if that decision is made by Scotia Bank, I think that the public need to be aware of it. Because you're saying to me that if I do any transaction via teller or via ATM, I'm going to be charged $2, which I find is unfair. So people need to be aware of these things. And if Scotia Bank is making that decision, and people always have a choice, we now have to decide what we do from here. We can't allow a bank to dictate to us that they're going to take our savings of $2 per transaction when we are trying now to save the best that we can.
Mrs. Charles Curtin says after receiving the letter, she called the bank to follow up. She says the new measure warrants an explanation.
I definitely is considering changing bank account. Because at the end of the day, if you in a financial institution and it's not doing justice to you, you have a choice. Now, the other concern I have is that, what about the people who are not able to get this letter, right? Or the people who are not literate enough to read the letter? Then that money will be deducted from them without even they having knowledge. And the other thing about Scotia Bank is one of the banks who don't give you the account status in terms of having a book. They don't give you this deposit book anymore. My husband also got a copy of the letter. Apparently they have different amount because his is indicating $3 per transaction, where mine is indicating $2 per transaction. So I do not know if they may have $4 transaction or whatever the case may be, but he's varying in terms of the amount per transaction.
Mrs. Charles Curtin states that as a financial advisor, she encourages people to save. However, she believes the new bank charges might just be causing people to spend more money, as they will be tempted to withdraw more from the ATM to reduce the number of transactions they conduct. For the DBS News World, Jason Hullingseed reporting.